everything can be described with one view. If it is system is complex, we have to consider many viewpoints, so many structures. That's why I say architecture has one way, one or many viewpoints or structures, and each structure have only one view. One view, like structure, one structure explaining one view of the system, one view of the system, and one view can have many representation, each structure captures one view, and a single view have many representation. එතකොට මේ analysis එකකට තේම software architecture can be seen as a collection of views here. This seven views here, collection of views. එතකොට මෙතන මේ structure comprised of this seven structure. When I explain software architecture is considering these seven viewpoints. Each viewpoint captures one view. All right. එතකොට මේ diagram එක ගත්තොත් architecture comprise of seven views. Architecture can be described using seven views. Make a structure again a kamta karot abhi. Terms of the architecture can be expressed using these seven views. These are these views. Each view can be represented in many ways. For example, database view එක අපිට explain කරන්න පුළුවන්, ER diagram එක පාවිච්චි කරන්න පුළුවන්, SQL එක පාවිච්චි කරන්න පුළුවන්, SQL script එක නැත්නම් relational model එක පාවිච්චි කරන්න පුළුවන්. Now I will try to give an example for you.
Can you try this exercise, sir?
Identify here. Question is decomposition view captures system is viewed as a set of decomposed programmable units. If you use this view, what are the main programming units that comprise of this system? What are the main programming units that comprise this system? Identify the decomposed programmable units. Given the structure, identify the decomposed programming units. මේ PowerPoint එක ඔයගලන්ට මම කිසිමාන එව්වා මේ take this PowerPoint and try to answer this question. I will post the question in the chat. That make up the system That is a decomposition view. Describing the decomposition view. So enter login details module use depends on this verify login details. So what are the enter login modules? Enter the login details to verify this this verify module. That means verify login depends on the enter login. Dependency bit, there is a dependency between these two modules. Verify because for the verification we need two details are required. The verification we purpose details need to be entered. Therefore, verify depends on the enter login. So this is captured in the dependency view. We add relations among modules to the decomposition view to create dependency view. So the dependency view therefore shows all the dependencies between that can exist between modules. Can I have one more example for this?
Oh yeah, if you take this slide,
I can see really clearly this one. Verify login. Verify login, use enter login here. Enter login, users relationships, right? This enter login module, verify login module, use relationships. Likewise, here we need for verification, we need to compare the login, entered login, compare the enter login. What the user enter in the window have to compare with the what is in the database. So you pass the your login details to the database module, which will compare what you entered with the what you retrieved from the database. What you retrieved from the database. That is dependency.
Use of
dependency and decomposition view. Since decomposition view captures the module decomposition, how the module can be decomposed into others. So it will help the project managers to distribute the works among people. So for example, now here, enter login and verification can be handed over to the programmer A. Viewing module can be handed over to programmer B and so on. Right. Also, dependency view helpful in a project planning to monitor the project progress. So that dependency view is useful in impact analysis. To take the dependency view, we can see that dependencies are there. Dependencies are there. You see now, compare free module. This is a free module because this is not depending on any other modules. Source send message module is a free module. It's not depending on any other. Enter login is free module. It does not depend on any other free module. These free modules can be implemented and tested in isolation. They make an cut view cut to them, view module is depending on this one. Therefore, it is not without compare module. It is difficult to test the verify module. Also, without the results of the compare module, it is difficult to, it's not possible to test the verify module. make a develop karanna puluwan etakota in the verify module we have to so this module can implement develop and test isolation but this cannot be tested so we can using dependency we can identify what are the free modules which can be independent developed and tested that's one application of the dependency another application is that we can use for the impact analysis impact analysis which I will explain later in the later slide in detail in the generalization we captures the classes that make up the system that may make up the system we can add class relations also for this class relations also can be added to this instead of additional classes class relations also there so what are the classes that relation that exists between classes association is normal association one object of one class can be associated to another object in another class simple association we can make generalization specialization relationship like Easter relationship within the parent class you can create specialization you can create child classes from the parent class we can create child classes making Easter relationships aggregation composition there's a container big class which consists of smaller that's a big object which consists of smaller objects and the big object contains this small object etara composition kin composition aggregation ekama wage yanne namuth ek loku container ekak thiyenawa the container athule thawa podi objects thiyenawa that will make this aggregation or composition relationships like container ekak gattoth container is a big object within that we have some other objects like petti tiyenna puluwam fruit boxes then vegetable boxes right then other commodities etukoda food boxes ayilla they are make a sub object the vegetable objects is another sub object then we have beverage objects beamer objects ether container ekathule lota wenath vargawala objects tiyenna petti tiyenna puluwam boxes can be there so that is a composition like composition and aggregation so aggregation composition dekama common property ekak thamai loku object ekak thiyena eka athule thama sub objects thiyena car ekak gattot ema car ekak gatti big one big thing content object samai body object samai engine ekak gear box ekak chassis ekak seats tire ekak content object right window එකක් ගත්තොත් එම window එකේ එතකොට පොඩි පොඩි කැරියෝ නැහැ window එක ඇදිලා තියෙන්නේ so this small objects collectively makes a big thing human body එක ගත්තොත් let's say we are human body then the parts like human the internal parts like the brain heart kidney liver and this hands legs hands and so on those are the constituent part So what is the difference between aggregation and composition is that in aggregation content object they can live without the container composition එක ගත්තොත් content objects වලට life එකක් නැහැ without the container look at without the big thing the content objects they don't have a life that's the difference right නැයි කණි අනිත් පැත්තේ ඒක ඒක තමයි නේ කන්ටෙන්ට් කම්පොෂන් එක කරලා මේක ලයිෆ් එකක් නෑ කන්ටෙන්ට් වලට මේ කන්ට්‍රේ එක නැතුව ඇග්‍රිගේෂන් එකේදී ලයිෆ් එකක් තියෙනවා එතකොට ගත්තොත් එහෙම තමයි අර කන්ටේනර් එකයි අර ෆුඩ් බොක්සස් ඒක එක්සැම්පල් එක ගත්තොත් එහෙම ඒක ඇග්‍රිගේෂන් එකක් දෙස නැග්‍රිගේෂන් ද කන්ටේනර් එක නැතුව කන්ට්‍රේට් එක නැතුවත් මේ අර කඩේට අයින් කරලා ගන්න we can take this out a food object එක තියෙනවා ඒක විනාශ වෙන්නේ නැහැ නේ වෙජිටබල් පෙට්ටියක තියෙනවා ඒක විනාශ වෙන්නේ නැහැ beverage is epithetic at the end, right? So that's making an aggregation relation. මට දෙන්න පුළුවන් ඒ වගේම කාර් කාර් එකත් ඒකත් ඇග්‍රිගේෂන් එකක් මොකද එන්ජින් එක කාර් එන්ජින් එකයි ජිය බොක්ස් එකයි ඒවා පැවැත්ම ලයිෆ් එකක් තියෙනවා කාර් එක නැති වුණත් මේක ගිල්ල වෙනතනක ෆික්ස් කරන්න පුළුවන් නමුත් බොඩි හියුමන් බොඩි එක ගත්තොත් එහෙම හියුමන් බොඩි එක liver එක එතන ගියාම heart එක brain එක ඒවට ඉන්ඩිවිජුවල් පැවැත්මක් නැහැ they have no life individually but they have connected no connections they have no they don't have individual life alone මේ ට්‍රාන්ස්ප්ලැන්ට් කියන කමත් එකලා දාන්න ජිස්පකටව ට්‍රාන්ස්ප්ලැන්ටින් ඉන්ඩිවිජුවලි දේ ඩොන්ට් හැව් ලයිෆ් අලෝන් සෝ දැට්ස් මේක කම්පොසිෂන් දස් කන්ටිනුවල් පැවැත්මක් නැහැ මේ කන්ටෙන් කන්ටෙන් එක නැතුව බොඩි එක නැතුව එන්ටයර් බොඩි නැතුව කන්ටිනුවල් පැවැත්මක් නැහැ ඒතකොට දැට්ස් මේක කම්පොසිෂන් රිලේෂන්ෂිප්ස් සෝ දීස් අයිඩියාස් ආර් කැප්චර්ඩ් ඉන් ජෙනරලයිසේෂන් වියු සෝ ජෙනරලයිසේෂන් වියු ඉස් හෙවිලි යූස්ඩ් ඉන් ඔබ්ජෙක්ට් ඔරියන්ටඩ් ඩිසයින් in a better in the design it will use then the text is in my diagram එක you can see that an example payment different ඊට අමතරව මේ is relation එකක් තියෙනවා is captured here generalization specialization is a user relations collectively called that means from the parent class we can create subclasses any number of subclasses So this diagram captures all these five types of relationships. But after that, you know, it's not mentioned here. You can go, you can browse the sites, Google, and you can get the details of that. May someone may pass the nagatam then tati. Then here payment, different payment methods: credit payments, check payments, cash payments. This association customer makes an order. One customer can make many orders. So for single order, there could be many payments. There could be many payments. That means payment can be done in installation. Payments can be done in one or many installation. Partly payments can be completed partly. Let me go on the example. Let me real example. Let me show can understand. The method order consists of order items. Order got to the one. You make an order, then order details you can find in the receipt. Order details. So order details for each order details contains list of order items. Order items. Item number one, item number two, item number three, item number four. When you make an order, let's say you are making online purchasing, you add items to the cart. Add item to the cart. That you are making an order. If you are buying multiple items, order consists. Order item, order details contains all the orders you made. Through order, ek order detail object hai ga. Order detail kya na ek object hai. ඒක මොනවාද තියෙන්නේ ඒක ඔඩර් ඩීටේල් ඔබ්ජෙක්ට් එකේ මොනවාද තියෙන්නේ එතකොට තමන් ඔඩර් කරපු අයිටම්ස් විතර ඔබ්ජෙක්ට්ස් මොනවාද ඔඩර් ඩීටේල්ස් කියන ඔබ්ජෙක්ට් එකේ ක්ලාස් එකේ ඉන්ස්ටන්ස් මොනවාද ඉන්ස්ටන්ස් මොනවාද ඉන්ස්ටන්ස් මොනවාද තමන් කරපු ඔඩර් කරපු ඔඩර් ලයින් 1 ලයින් 2 ලයින් 3 and so on order detail object එකේ class එකේ අපිට ඕන තරම් order lines order line order items create කරන්න පුළුවන් and so order details contains order line item line item so order detail contains line item or order line each line item contain the item so item you can therefore relate order details into item class එක ලයින් ඓටම් එකකම තියෙන එක ඓටම් එකයි ඉන්න සිංගල් ලයින් ඓටම් we have only one corresponding item see ඓටම් එකේ description එක තියෙනවා එයාගේ other details price එක මොකද්ද unit price එක description එක item name එක ඓටම් එක සම්බන්ධ other details you know right ඒතර මේ ඒ details order detail එකට වඩා නැහැ එක තියෙන ඓටම් එකේ So it's making a relationship here, association. तो मैं कहता हूँ क्लासिकल एग्जांपल लगा इस फॉर कैप्चरिंग जनरलाइजेशन में यू सो मैं कहता हूँ ये तो कंपोनेंट्स बनाओ इफ यू टेक मॉड्यूल व्यू व्हाट आर द मॉड्यूल्स दैट कैप्चर्स इन दिस डायग्राम मॉड्यूल्स आर कस्टमर ऑर्डर पेमेंट क्रेडिट्स कैश ऑर्डर डिटेल्स आइटम डिपेंडेंसी बना दे रिलेशन बना दे मेन मेन एसोसिएशन जनरलाइजेशन एग्रीगेशन एसोसिएशन तीन सो यूज ऑफ जनरलाइजेशन यूज इन दिस यूजफुल वेन डिजाइनिंग एक्सटेंडेबल आइडेंटिफाइंग एक्सटेंडेबल सॉफ्टवेयर यूनिट्स एक्सटेंडेबल सॉफ्टवेयर यूनिट्स So payment is extendable software units. Payment. You see, in this module we can useful when designing extendable software units. We can create extension for payment, credit, cash, check. Other if other payment methods are there, you can simply expand this class diagram by adding more. Common data and functions can be in placed in common data and their methods can be behaviors can be made in parent class. Specific attributes and specific methods can place in credit cash in this subclass. The matrix ගලන්න පහදෙලි ගොඩක් වෙලාට දැන් මෙතන මේ decomposition डिपेंडेंसी जनरलाइजेशन भी पैदली है लम कंफ्यूज करने का इंप्लीमेंटेशन इंप्लीमेंटेशन आप कथा कर टॉकिंग अबाउट सॉफ्टवेयर सिस्टम दैट कंसिस्ट ऑफ नॉट सिंगल प्रोग्राम और टू थ्री प्रोग्राम्स वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट फीडिंग सिस्टम इज कॉम्प्लेक्स देयर कुड बी हंड्रेड्स ऑफ hundreds of modules maybe it could be more than that thousands of modules depending on the complexity of the software system then when you are documenting how to identify this then methana module yak thiyenawa login kiyala or verify kiyala module yak thiyenawa hari e module ekata etakota it's one of the module among the large collection of modules Then we, how are we going to identify what is the corresponding source file? Or the corresponding source file? Are you going to store details about the source file? Because if you want to do some any modification to the module, you have to address directly the code. So how to identify correctly what is the exactly the relevant code file that you want to modify among the large collection of so implementation you capture just these details so module verify its name is verify is implementation can be found in verify.java eto eka document ekak liyanna puluwan simple gana table ekak gam टेबल लेके गए थे मैं कहाँ पे डॉक्यूमेंट कराने बोला तो अगर वेरीफाई की ना मॉड्यूल लेके इंप्लीमेंटेशन कोड देके दिए ने एक verify.java इमने तंग में अपने कंपोनेंट डायग्राम में आक अंदला मैं इधर एक्सप्लेन करना पुला एक्सप्लेन करना पुलवा मॉड्यूल्स का वैल्यू नोते कंफ्यूजिंग डायग्राम में लोक डायग्राम में लोक इन दैट केस यू कैन ऑल्सो यूज अ टेबल ऑल्सो राइट टेबल ऑल्सो बट इंप्लीमेंटेशन टू डिस्क्राइब द इंप्लीमेंटेशन यू कैन यूज कंपोनेंट डायग्राम सो इतना डायग्राम में मॉड्यूल्स मॉड्यूल्स रिलेशंस आइडेंटिफाई ऑल्सो implementation you will capture you know it's a verify in a source code එක verify.java pangani patent එක අතාරිනවා compare කියන module එකේ source code එකේ නම compare.java in account ethic I will omit them in the discussion. So that's implementation view. So implementation view maps the software module into its source file that contains the implementation. Maps the ඊට මම ඔයගලන්ට ප්‍රශ්නයක් දුන්නත් මේ what implementation view does is what implementation view captures is what implementation captures is mapping details of software module to its code mapping details so relation between software module and its where its code can found software modules is mapped into its relevant source code details or you can also add data files modules where relevant data files can be find not only CPP not only code but also some other documents relevant documents are there but are the associated data files मॉड्यूल आवश्यक डेटा इवागे डिजाइन डॉक्यूमेंट्स मॉड्यूल अदाला डिजाइन डॉक्यूमेंट्स को सो दैट हेल्प्स प्रोग्रामर टू फाइंड द इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ द सॉफ्टवेयर मॉड्यूल अमंग द सास लार्ज कलेक्शन ऑफ सोर्स फाइल एंड विद अदर रिलेवेंट डॉक्यूमेंट्स नॉट ओनली सोर्स कोड बट ऑल्सो अदर रिलेवेंट डॉक्यूमेंट्स कैन बी प्रोक्यूर्ड If you require, that is the same idea of implementation view. Then next one is execution view. Now you have source code is there. Now you want to compile this and create an executable file, executable version. So every module, every source file, every source code has its relevant exe file. So this execution view shows the runtime details, runtime view of this modules identify. In the execution view. In the implementation, in implementation, we have the source code. The execution view it's mapped to relevant executable body. Relevant executable body. Each component source code has relevant executable counterpart. In other words, exe file, and its execution create a relation between. The source code file and execution file. Execution file. In this execution view, this module execution. We are using the metadata stereotype source standard. Me saying that this is the source file. Stereotype source is using to say that this is a source code. Stereotype. Binary is used to say that this is the exe file, binary file. Java to make it. We are creating a class file here. Object byte code dega Java file. Enter ke byte code dega Java enter dot class. Verify ke byte code dega verify. Depending on the language, if it is Java, it could be a bytecode or it could be a exe also, right? The relation ne ka link. The execution level ka abo ama main implementation bhi ek hai deti hai neta use ek ame executable ka abo ama the relation is link. It will become link because. This module should link verify module at execution level should link enter login exe me program එක මේ exe මේ program එක call කරන්න ඕනේ is calling this program at execution level it will, the relation is a link relation is link implementation level එකේදී relation එක use implement execution level එකේදී relation එක link වෙනවා නම link වෙනවා right එතන අපි program එකක් තියෙනවා එතකොට අපි call කරන්නේ exe file එකනේ call කරන්නේ exe file එක මගේ මගේ ප්‍රෝග්‍රෑම් එකේ exe file එක ඇතුලේ මම කෝල් කරනවා තව exe file එක linking that exe file to this program then deployment view these exe files should be run somewhere in the hardware what are the relevant hardware that exe file execute at runtime so its deployment view will map items units in the execution view into computer resources when you say computer resources it can be processors databases and communication networks databases communication networks three main processors hardware thin I mean resources CPUs resources memory resource and network resource මේ program එක run වෙන්නේ මොන machine එකේ මොන CPU එකද single machine can have multiple CPUs multiple processors so this program can be in distributed environment this program can be assigned to machine A one CPU or machine B another CPU එතකොට මේ exe file එක run වෙන්නේ මේ exe file එක run වෙන්නේ ඒ කියන්නේ machine එකේ පළවෙනි CPU එකේ first processor එකේ මේ exe file එක run වෙන්නේ machine එකේ දෙවෙනි processor එකේ මොකද්ද usage එක ඒ වගේම data files මොකද මේකේදී එතකොට implementation එකේදී is also capturing the data files and relevant documents relevant documents so data file lang etukota if it is using some database if the module exe file is using some database a database eka tiyenne mona database eke mona data store eke සමහරක් ප්‍රෝග්‍රෑම් එකක් පාවිච්චි කරන්න පුළුවන් එක ඩේටාබේස් එකක් එක්කොට ඒ ඩේටාබේස් එක තියෙන්නේ මොන කම්පියුටරේ මොන ඩේටාබේස් එකේ තව ප්‍රෝග්‍රෑම් එකක් පාවිච්චි කරන්න පුළුවන් තව කම්පියුටරේ තව සර්වර් එකක් ඒතකොට ඒ ඩේටාබේස් එක වෙන එක ඒක තියෙන්නේ වෙන මැෂින් එකක so in deployment we can capture this idea this diagram is explained here you can see a the email program is running in this server but me diagram read karan ban is give an idea about what are executable components is this mapping into computer hardware here computer resources please look at this slide to understand whether you can read it So my diagramming it's clear apparent that
so this is the
hardware there is a proxy here email server web server so this is a system not only for this particular application there are other servers as well then me api dan ape application ekak illa email application ekak pawanai aba application is only an email application but that system might contains other application as well. උදාහරණ කිහිපයක් ගත්තොත් යුනිවර්සිටි එකේ ඊමේල් සර්වර් එකක් තියෙනවා. There is a separate email server. Also, there are this is separate LMS server. LMS server. Also, there are other applications which are running the ERP of the university. ERP ERP application that handles human resources and marks and so on. The marking system, a grade examination එකට mark system එකක් marking system එක වෙනම තියෙන්න පුළුවන්. Could be a separate application.
Hello.
Hello කියන්න.
Say screen එක share කරන්න. Screen එක share කරලා
නැහැ. ඒ ටකල එමුණු ටකල මට කියන්න ඕනේ මේ මේ සමහරට මේ මාරු වෙනකොට screen web server that means in maintaining university website එක is සමහර මේ ඔය combine වෙනත් පුළුවන් website එකයි mail server එකයි that could be to maintain at the same machine with different ports the email වලට වෙනම email service එකට වෙනම port එකක් තියෙනවා web service එකට වෙනම port එකක් තියෙනවා assume for the sake of explanation there are separate web server separate email server separate database server separate application servers application service there which runs marks management system or some other applications like human resource management teachers luggage or student management application that supporting educational activities and so on to the Giga servers, you know, for specific functionality. Email run when ne, toka me email server ke. That is captured in the email deployment view. Then your web application is running, website is running on web server. That's captured in here. So web application on a web server ke. Then the database is running on database server. All application programs are running in application server. So this is all captured in the deployment view. Also, it has servers includes these processors in all, and also data database component. All data is stored here. Student data and other marks and everything. Employee data, teachers in the database server, and network also. Now you see now all web server and email server interacting with outside through the proxy. So they are going. They are all message exchanges through the proxy that filtering the things before sending out. Also, when people are coming, entered the system is also coming through the proxy outside. So you say interactions from the outside, and they talk to the email server to the proxy. So it's another filtering here taking place, filter for security purpose, and all these are connected. To the internet, so they make up internal zone. So far to the firewall, you connect to the outside.
So in the requirement we
all your things in your execution views, things in your execution view are mapped into the relevant computer resources.
So make it, what are the
use of this? In this, what purpose the deployment you can be used? But some questions are all that, you know, then what is the use of dependency? What is the use of generalization? Evage prashna all that, you know, then what is the use of deployment? Evage prashna ekma all na hai. So what is the use of dependency view? What is the use of execution view? What is the use of deployment view? In particular, in this case, what is the use of deployment view? Using this view captures the details where your executable entities are running at the execution time. Your execution entities are which computer resources are, which in other words, generalized, which hardware resources they are using at the execution level. In other words, deployment view captures what hardware resources they are using at the execution level. So deployment view captures the details about the hardware resources the execution entities are using. Simple explanation. So statement taking deployment view describe or captures what hardware resources are used by the executional entities, executable entities. But the use of this helps the computer architect to identify which hardware resources should be monitored. So the deployment, using the details in deployment view, somehow at testing level you have to do some testing, no? System testing level, at the system testing level, so you have to check whether the system meets some quality attributes, or whether it's the required functional requirements are met. So in that case, you have to monitor these behaviors, these programs. So this program is running somewhere using some computer resources. So which hardware resources we should monitor? Then if it is a single computer, it's simple application, doesn't matter. It's a large company. Then Microsoft team size big software companies, lot of projects, lot of people, lot of resources, for example, for system testing, one program is running on one computer, another program is running on computer. So this will help architect to evaluate its system qualities like performance, reliability, security by monitoring the relevant computer resources. If you go through these details here, this application is running, is using these resources. Then directly the architect can monitor those resources. You can just monitor what's happening. To measure these attributes to see its functional behavior. It's called functional behavior. It's operational behavior. We have to check the operational behavior.
එතකොට security case එකේදී මේ proxy එක තියෙනවා. එතකොට ගණිගාම ගොඩක් අනිත් could be one proxy or couple of proxy. එතකොට network manager පුළුවන්. එතකොට මේ diagram එක use කරන්න any if any size so whatever network diagram you can get an initial understanding about the network structure of the system by looking at this diagram. Looking at this diagram, a useful diagram deployment. The diagram that captures the deployment. Then work assignment view. Whatever the modules you identify, whatever the implementation you captures, so whatever the deployment you captures, ultimately whatever the dependency you captures, all these modules has to be developed by someone or group or people. So this you capture those details. This you capture those details, work assignment view. So using this view, decomposition view, the decomposed system modules can be distributed for the development and assigned to project teams to development to be carried out. So in other words, decompose the system development into work tasks that can be assigned to project teams.
So
මේක අරගෙන මේ මේක assignment එක තියෙනවා. එතකොට here example here, this part of the system is allocated for this team A. This is a work assignment to you. This is a graphical representation. You can also use graphical representation as well as you can express these things in some other form. Text details also sufficient for this. So these modules are assigned for team A, which comprises of ABC individuals. So they can be documented how somehow. It could be using a diagram, or it could be using some other way, like in textual mode. Describing the scenario. තම මේ diagram එකකින් සරලව ඉදිරිපත් කළා දින මේක. So this assign for this team, these modules are assigned for development work, is assigned for this team, for this assigned for this individual.
What is the use of this
work assignment to you? It helps project managers to plan and allocate project resources. Plan and allocate project resources.
The project
managers have these details. Team A, these modules will be assigned the computer resources, computer A or server A, whatever hardware. This team or individual assign the development work of these modules, which during that process we can use these resources, right? Therefore, this view can help project managers to plan and allocate project resources to human resources, project resource assigning project resources to human resources. A work assignment view, in other words, captures, helps project managers to allocate project resources among human resources. And also it helps track project progress. Track project progress. Project progress. අපි දන්නවා ඒතර මේ modules එක දුන්නේ මේ team එකට. That information also information are captured in this view. This description is there. So straight away එතකොට මේ මොඩියුල් සෙට් එක දීලා තින්නේ මේ ටීම් එකට. එතකොට කෙලින්ම ඒ මොඩියුල් සෙට් එකේ if you want to know the state of that module set, what is the current state of this module set? Is it under testing or under still under development? If it is testing, what state? Then definitely you can then talk with the peer 11 people to how to measure the progress. So team members identify can identify the team members so individuals who are responsible, and then you can talk directly with them to measure the project progress. So may 7 new scenario ekata they don't have given a specific name. Specific name is not mentioned, but this can think of as this generic approach for software architecture documentation, which captures different views, 7 views to explain various aspects of the system, various aspects of the system, starting from development to up to the development start and up to the conclusion. So we have, of course, this is a very big chapter. We have to continue it. The first part, first section of the chapter is then you go move to the second section of this chapter. We want to know detailed about this and further.
Any question
regarding this? View, sir.
So if you
look at this slide, structures that are viewpoints. So viewpoint is a collection of views.
Structures, viewpoints.
So my collection is this case. Each of these will be one viewpoint that captures. That address one view is one viewpoint that address the system in taking one single view.
Next part
of this presentation, this chapter.
Now this 7 views
now. We can condense. We can the 7 views now can be condensed into three categories, three baskets. The 7 views can be condensed further into three groups, three categories. What are these three categories? The categories basically address static behavior of the system, dynamic behavior of the system, and non-software architecture aspects, sir. Static.
So we label them as module.
Structure, component and connector structure, allocation structure.
Module structure.
Component and connected structure and allocation structure. අර හත තමයි දැන් අපි කඩන්න යන්නේ. 7 can be assigned into three baskets. Three baskets are labeled as module structure, component and connected structure, and allocation structure. බලමු අපි දැන් how we are going to place these 7 views under three baskets under these three baskets. So module structure, how it is structured as set of implementation unit capturing a static behavior.
So how the system is
in particular, how the system is structured, organized. How the system is organized. Organized as
set of
categories, module structure, module structure describe how system is organized
into a set of
implementation units capturing static behavior, or the system is organized as set of units which can be implemented capturing static behavior. Then second main structure is component connector structure,
and third one is
allocation structure.
So module structure captures
static behavior, component and connector structure captures dynamic behavior or runtime behavior. So in this component connector structure, system is organized as a set of elements that are interacting with each other. Set of elements that are interacting with each other. This allocation structure, system components are related to its, system components are system components are related to a non-software structure and its environment. System components are related to a non-software structure and its environment. අප හත දැන් බලමු මේ 3 baskets වල දාන්න කොහොමද we'll see how this put into this 3 basket module component and connect and allocation. Now this diagram explain that module structure here use decomposition view, dependency view and generalization view. Module structure, if I add one more slide to this, then see you
hello. Or a component and a component view. Location structure captures may mask the anapula implementation view. Implementation view put a copy of slide deck polygon. So let's see. Decomposition dependency allocation structure structures can be classified into three groups, three main structures: module structure, decomposition and connect module structure, component and connector structure, and allocation structure. So under module structure, it composed of decomposition view, dependency view, generalization view. Component connector structure captures execution view. Allocation structure captures implementation, deployment, and allocation view. Module structure के capture करने में static behavior component and connector structure ke captures dynamic behavior execution view allocation structure captures social aspect and it's like non-software structure, non-software elements, non-software elements, non-software elements. In terms of hardware and human resources. Allocation. Then I'm allocation. Allocation kiwa meto kada allocate karna. Something allocating. Allocate to whom? Allocate to whom? It could be allocate to human or it could be allocate to some hardware or some allocate to some executable entities. Module, then it comes decomposition, dependency and generalization. Decomposition, generalization, can class diagrams, dependency view, explain a dependency diagram, users view, dependency diagram. So under which you can use decomposition diagram, class diagram, dependency diagram can be used for under module structure, explain its static behavior. Decomposition diagram, class diagram, and dependency diagram can be used to explain the module structure. Then component and connector. So, different styles are being used for this purpose. Different styles, if you want to explain module structure, different styles are used. What are these styles? Layered architecture. Layered architecture can be used. Layered style can be used in explaining module structure. Layered style. So layered style, main subrouting style for decomposition. Main subrouting style for decomposition. Shown in this diagram here. So in explaining module style, module structure, decomposition style, that is main subrouting style we discuss. Then generalization styles, class diagrams we discuss. Dependency diagram we discuss. User style, layered style we discuss. Layered style and data model style. DFT got to think object oriented I think. Now DFT also can be used to explain the module style. Repository style we all discuss. Repository style. There are module style. Module style එකේ අපි මේ architectural styles use කරන්න පුළුවන්. In the spreading module style, we can use this architectural style depending on the application, different styles can be used. When we are capturing a module, explaining module structure, decomposition style already considered, main subrouting style. Generalization style we explain class diagrams, layered style we discuss, we haven't discussed this one. Repository style can be also used, data centered architecture, data model style, that is DFD diagrams, etc. And user style, style explaining the dependency view. So to explain component connector style, what are the runtime entities? What are the captures that capture? What are the entries that capture runtime behavior? Make the Abikatagara pipe and filter interactions. Pipe and filter client server style and service oriented. Service oriented. These three styles are discussed. අපිට කතා කරන්න දෙයක් peer to peer, publisher subscriber, multi tier shared data. මේකත් අපි කතා කරා මේ shared repository කියන්නේ මේකට එන්නේ. When you're explaining this components connected style, that second category, these architectural style can be used. So, the component connector style like මේ අපතරම වයින්වා ඉතින් ගම්වතුර ගන්න මම දන්න අද සිටුේෂන් about you වයිකින් කො අපතරම කොබි ඩෙල්ටා වයින්වත් බෑ මේ you have to be careful we'll try to manage in somehow allocation style allocation namema pahadili wenawa allocate kiyanne allocate karanna koheda it could be allocate for hardware namen thirunga lesi allocation style describe where these entities could be allocated it could be to hardware it could be for human component deployment style this can be assigned to computer resources and deployment cell we can be computer resources installation style came to map to exe files work assignment style we can map to human human components so meva combine karanat puluwan this different styles can be combined when to make hybrid model so we further going to elaborate on module structure modules represent code base view of viewing the system describing static behavior module represent a code based behavior code based view as in actually it's a code program in codes
So module represents
the code base way of viewing the system describing the static behavior.
So if it is class
diagram, what are the modules? Modules are classes. For the class diagram, modules are classes: customer, order, payment, credit, cash, check, order detail, item. These are the modules. If you take email example, modules are verify, compare, delete, view, send message, and so on.
That means each module
can be assigned some functional responsibility. Each module is an implementation unit. They can be called, will be assigned some functional responsibility. The assigning functional responsibility for modules happening in which stage? I have a question. Can you answer this question? Assigning functional responsibility modules done at what stage is done at designing stage. Are done at
deciding state. So identification of
modules. And assigning functional responsibilities are done at designing stage. Example for modules, given a class diagram, I mentioned. Also, the dependency views are also captured here. Dependency view, the relations. So modules can be related to other modules, as mentioned here early. They are captured in dependency view. So dependency view, because I have a module structure, got it? Dependency also belongs to module structure. So I have to add a dependency relate. Capture in dependency view.
Modules can relate to
other modules. Capturing dependency view.
What are the
dependencies that can exist between modules? whole part good idea. Ogalanta theory make a whole part. Aggregation composition. There is part of whole part can economize is part of people are using different words for the same thing is part of whole part aggregation composition cannot make it amai again make it katandriya aggregation එක ඩිපෙන්ඩ් ඔන් කන්ටේනර් කන්ටෙන්ට් කතන්දරය වෙන්නේ කන්ටේනර් කන්ටෙන්ට් කතන්දරය වෙන්නේ මෙතන මේ කන්ටේනර් කන්ටෙන්ට් මම ඩයග්‍රෑම් එක එක්ස්ප්ලේන් කරන්න මේක we go back to this part of part whole aggregation composition stand for the same thing you go back to this slide here again
Now, if you look at
is part of order. whole part kiyanne me toku ek whole part na me whole kiyanne loku ek hari hari whole kiyanne loku ek part kiyanne me whole kiyanne container ek loku ek whole kiyanne container ek loku ek whole part parts kiyanne me content ek This whole represent the big thing. Parts represent the constituent part. Again, whole part is a part of the get. They will hear that. My name is kya ne? Lokya ka part of kya ne? What did you from parents to mother? Aggregation kya? This aggregation contains parts. Itra aggregation kya ne? Me parts of life ya tina contain kya ne? Tuva aggregation composition කියන්නේ එතකොට content and life එකක් නැහැ මේ container එක නේද so this is part of whole part aggregation composition represent the same meaning sorry is part of එකයි whole part එකයි අපිට देख रहे बेदान बोलो एक एग्रीगेशन है कि न बोलो इस कैन बी एग्रीगेशन नो कंपोजिशन डिपेंडिंग ऑन द लाइफ ऑफ द कंटेंट ऑब्जेक्ट सो इस पार्ट ऑफ होल पार्ट कैन बी एन एग्रीगेशन इफ द कंटेंट हैज अ लाइफ विदाउट द कंटेनर इस पार्ट ऑफ ओ होल पार्ट विल बिकम अ कंपोजिशन इफ द कंटेंट डस नॉट हैव अ लाइफ विदाउट द कंटेनर If it is their classes, then we can have those relation dependency relationship. Relation ne kat misuno mathe is classes modules classes na you can add is relation as well. Okay, method demo is much more clear for you. We'll add it here.
Then there could be
use relationships that can exist between modules. The class diagram එක නැතුව module එකක් අපි ගත්තොත් එම it could be a function එකක් වගේ නේද? Method class diagram එකක තියෙන class එකක තියෙන objects තියෙන objects class එකක තියෙන objects තියෙනවා. Objects වල operations තියෙනවා methods තියෙනවා. ඒ methods they can use some other methods. For example, a method can use a library function. It is what a the other relation thing depend on depends or use depends on or depends on the kind of depends. Or the use relation, you know, it could be use. Uses.
Yeah, depends on the.
Defines a dependency relation between units A and B. Dependency relation.
Dependency
වලත් එකත් අපිට තව බෙදන්න පුළුවන් users allocate to use cross cut අපි එච්චර details වලට යන්න ඕනේ නැහැ dependency is use something use relationship dependency or use that a level එකේ නවතු then what are the users of this where we can use this module structure. Now can use this module structures. We can use decomposition style. We can use dependency style. We can use generalization style. What's this use? Can be used in traceability analysis. Impact analysis and they can use for communication purpose. Traceability analysis. Now each module is attached some functional requirement. As I mentioned earlier, each module will be assigned a certain functional responsibility. Each module will be assigned a certain functional responsibility. Now, at some point, it should be possible to determine how the functional requirements of the system of a system is assigned to modules. At one point, put time, it should be able to trace or determine, trace or locate. How the functional requirements of a system are assigned to modules, or trace which functional requirements are assigned to which modules. We can use this module structure for this purpose.
So when
you're explaining each module, we have to explain what is the module is doing. What is the module is doing? The module like describe can with the syntax that you know you have to use that syntax. Key features is now module has to be described. Module has to be described somehow. Diagram make a petty with the image. In the diagram, it is just like a box. We have assigned a name for the box, but there is more than that. The main petty mogadagra naming is only a small idea. Small idea can be captured from the name, but we need more details than that. For example, module has a name, small description. Module has a name, a small description about the module, what explaining what this module is doing.
So, in other words, can I explain which module, what functional responsibilities
are assigned for this module? Otherwise, you cannot trace that those details later. For example, let's take this diagram. The first column contains the requirement documents, which contain list of requirements. List of requirements.
And second column
contains the design components. So many other modules, many components. These are the components. My component, it could be capital D1. Capital D1 is another component, another module. Capital D2. Capital D2, another module. So this capital D1 module consists of smaller modules, simple D1, simple D2, and so on. The capital D2. මම දන්නම් එතන ඇත්තකට පොඩි මේකක් දාමු composed of simple D1, simple D2, එතකොට D1, D2, D3. So we now know requirement 22 is assigned to D1. You can add this diagram. We have a lecture at 4:30. R22 is assigned to D1, D2. D1, D2. D2, D1. And D3, D1. So you can in module 1, you can trace which requirement is assigned to which modules. You can locate this responsibility, you can identify this responsibility to its relevant modules. Now, P3 North, we will meet on Friday. Okay. Right, okay. We'll meet you next Friday, 1 o'clock.